Bo, we're speaking ahead of Watford this weekend, but first, you may have got a few more minutes than you're expecting last Sunday against Keynsham, but it was a good win in the FA Cup.
Yeah, fantastic. Obviously, it's a shame to hear about Jess, and everyone at the club is right behind us to get fully back on the pitch, back on the ball. But yeah, it was a good game. It was nice to see kind of how far the club have come from last season to this season, but without disrespecting Keynsham, because they gave us a battle in the first 10 minutes. I think that really pushed us as a team to really show, like, they're good teams in that league. Just because we've been promoted doesn't mean we should neglect what we've come back from. And I think they really, really pressed us in that and gave us a good game. And eventually we got some good goals, good communication on the field, good combination plays. And I think, yeah, we done well with it in the end.
And most importantly, it's now through to the second round where we've got another away game down at Plymouth to look forward to. You must be really excited for that.
Yeah, you know, it's a local rival, isn't it, in terms of with the men's game as well, like everyone knows the Argyle and City game. So I think it'll be a fantastic atmosphere. Last time we went down there, really credit to them of how many people they brought to the ground. And I hope that this will only fuel that and build a bigger crowd to get behind both teams and, yeah, bring the excitement to the game.
How's your week been away from the pitch? I saw you were up quite late last night.
Yeah, it's been busy, to say the least. I got to bed this morning at about 4:45. So I am extremely tired, but yeah, it's been okay, just very busy on the fire front.
It's the life of a semi-professional footballer. I feel like some supporters who maybe don't attend the women's games as much don't realise the way you have to balance the two roles.
Yeah, it's definitely a learning curve, for sure. I mean, not everyone's got it right in the field, and there's a lot of transition, especially from the younger players coming up through and going into kind of from, you know, your educational side into real life worlds and working how you really balance those two things. You know, you've got targets to hit at work, you've got commitments outside of this socially as well. Like, you can't just do football, you need to make sure that everyone's there ready for the games and ready for their life and family. But yeah, I think it's a unwritten message of the game of how much you really commit to it, and that's nutritionally, you know, making sure that you're making your right food so you're not snacking on the way here and there. And yeah, it's good, we'll get there.
Another part of your life, any player at Exeter, is those long away journeys, and you've got the first of a couple coming up now with Watford this weekend. What are you expecting from that game?
I thought you were going to ask me what I'm expecting from the bus. And
we'll get to that next.
Yeah, you know, Watford are fantastic sides. From last year, you know, they've got something to prove this year. They're very professional, very good in their setup, and bring an abundance of talent on the field. I think it's just for us to go up there and try and rattle some cages in terms of what we can bring as our club, being the new team and them coming down as the experienced team. We've got nothing to lose. Go out there, free hit, and see what we can do, and hopefully get a performance out of it.
And the bus?
The bus is going to be loud. So I'm going to stay away from all the youngsters because I'm now getting old.
Amazing. Thank you, Beth.
No worries.